Hello, my name is Carrie and this is our Kenmore Progressive Canister Vacuum, and one of the features I like about this vacuum is that when a dust bag needs to be changed, there is an indicator light that comes on to tell you the bag is full. To change the dust bag, I'll first turn the vacuum off and unplug the power cord from the outlet. Next, I'll remove the suction hose from the vacuum. To do this, I'll depress the tab on the hose latch. Then while the tab is depressed, I'll pull straight up on the suction hose to remove it. With the suction hose removed, I'll pull out on the hood latch and lift up on the canister hood. The hood will lock in the open position. Next, I'll grab the cardboard tab on the dust bag and pull out the tab from the red bag mount. This releases the bag and I can then remove the dust bag from the chamber. Notice that the red bag mount will flip forward when the bag is out. This prevents me from closing the hood before a new dust bag is installed. Before I install the new bag, I'll check the motor safety filter. The filter looks good, so I'll go ahead and install a new bag. This is the new bag. It's a HEPA bag that's supposed to remove particulates down to 0.3 microns. These bags are a little more expensive than regular bags, but we have a dog, so it seems like a good investment to me. To install a new bag, I'll tuck the bag into the chamber, rotate the red bag mount back, then install the cardboard tab from the new bag into the slots in the red bag mount. Then I need to check that none of the dust bag will be pinched when I close the hood. The bag looks good, so now I'm ready to close the hood. In this step, if I just push down on the front of the hood, it feels like I'm going to break the legs off that hold the hood up. But if I lift up on the bottom of each leg carefully, this will release the hood, and then I can lower it until it snaps into place. The next step is to take the suction hose, line up the hose latch, and snap it into place. Okay, the dust bag is changed, so I'll plug in the power cord and turn on the vacuum. Notice that with the new bag, the bag indicator light is off, and I'm ready to do some more cleaning. So that completes this video on how to change the dust bag on a canister vacuum. If you like this video, please share it and click the thumbs up. And if you'd like to see more of my videos, please visit my YouTube channel, Icekeeper1.